TEI Publisher 7.1 introduces a new web-based annotation editor, which, despite being a shiny new feature, is already used by a number of projects in production. It attempts to simplify one of the most tedious and time-consuming steps in the encoding workflow, that is, adding semantic, analytic, or text-critical markup to an existing transcription. By enabling editors to apply annotations in the browser, TEI Publisher eases the burden of the enrichment phase by allowing editors to mark everything within a user-friendly environment, closely resembling the publication view. The starting point for the enrichment process in TEI Publisher is an existing raw transcription, for example as acquired by a recognition tool like Transcribus, a word import, or a manual transcription. Let's call this the base text. After uploading it to TEI Publisher, the markup can be enriched in an iterative process. In a way, this corresponds to an old-fashioned paper-based review. You print out the text, then use a marker to highlight certain passages, write corrections over the text with a pen, or scribble notes into the margin. Once back at your computer, the changes need to be transferred into the TEI. You may then continue with a second round of review by printing out the results again, and so on. Within our electronic environment, the printout corresponds to the source TEI document, and the marks and scribbles are annotations. Until you explicitly merge the annotations into the source TEI, they will be kept separate from the document they apply to. Once merged, a new version of the source TEI document is established, and the editing process restarts. Let's switch to TEI Publisher and look at a document. TEI Publisher detects existing markup in the base text when it is loaded. The editor is non-destructive in that it accepts any TEI and will never touch or modify any markup outside the elements recognized as annotations. Let's start with a simple semantic annotation and mark up William as a person. However, we would not only like to encode William as a person name, but also connect it to an external authority. TEI Publisher has a number of authorities built in, and more are currently added by the community. By default, the German GND is configured as our authority for people. Obviously, the GND knows many Williams, but we can refine our search by adding Graves and then selecting the correct entry. In the preview pane to the right, we now see an HTML display of the text, which corresponds to what users would later see in the application. Whenever you change something, TEI Publisher generates a temporary preview of the resulting TEI and renders it via the ODD configured for the resource. We can thus check the effect at any time. In fact, both the annotation editor and the preview are based on an ODD with TEI processing model instructions. Both views are thus fully configurable via the standard you already know, that is TEI. We can also confirm if our annotation would be correctly applied to the TEI source by switching to the TEI tab. As you can see, William has been correctly encoded as a person name with a ref attribute referring to the GND ID. Note that the attribute used is also configurable, so you could change it to a key or a corsp, or whatever you prefer. Now let us encode a place. Let's choose Madrid. This time, the authority lookup is done against geonames.org. Once we select the entry for Madrid, we see two other occurrences listed in the left sidebar. They are not checked, meaning there's no annotation on them yet. We can mouse over the highlighted terms, and the display scrolls to the place where they occur, thus giving us a chance to look at the context. To mark all three occurrences at once, we just click on the Apply All button on top. Annotations can also be used for analytic or text-critical markup. For example, we may want to encode the typo works with a choice sig core. Obviously, this results in more complex markup within the TEI. Nesting annotations is handled as well. For example, we may want to encode the expression Church of San Francisco as a term, referencing a church, and since here we are using GND, we have to use the German Kirche. The little handle inserted at the end of every annotation makes it easy to understand the nesting hierarchy. One can click on it to modify or delete an annotation. The available annotations are fully configurable, including the mapping to TEI. You can easily add your own by following the simple steps described in the documentation. We also have a special annotation for quick edits, which actually modifies the base text. This comes in handy if you find an obvious error in your transcription. For example, we may find that Juanito in fact appears as Juan in the original. Just click the pen icon and enter the correction. You are allowed to save the document at any time, thus merging the current set of annotations into the TEI and establishing a new base text. As you can see, the display is refreshed after the save, but all previous annotations are again detected, except for the quick edit, which is the only annotation which vanishes without a trace in the encoding.
At the Office of the Historian in the U.S. Department of State, we began using TEI Publisher's web-based annotation facility earlier this summer to enrich our already published TEI encoded diplomatic documents, such as this one. This tool filled a major hole in our plan to annotate the instances of key people, places, organizations, and subjects mentioned in each document. We long found it cumbersome to perform annotations in our XML editor, and have long yearned for a web-based tool that would let us look at a clean rendering of our base text, read it naturally, and apply annotations directly and efficiently. After evaluating several alternative annotation tools, we decided to help commission an annotation facility in TEI Publisher, which we already use to render our TEI content. We are thrilled with the results, a free, open source, extensible, web-based annotation tool that lets us fluidly and efficiently annotate our documents. Let me briefly demonstrate the tool as we've adapted it. This is our annotation application, which was generated by TEI Publisher's app generator. We're looking at a document from 1985 about a meeting at the White House between US and Soviet officials. We see several annotations have already been applied, but there is a mention of the president which has not yet been annotated. When we select this text and select the Person Annotation button, the tool sends a query to our entity database, housed in a cloud-based tool called Airtable. The query asks Airtable for any people whose name or list of variant names matches the text. As you can see by examining the entity summary panel, we have already registered the president as an alternate name for Ronald Reagan, so we can simply select this plus icon to confirm that this is the entity we want to associate with the text we had selected. Next, the editor presents us with a list of all matches in the document for this entity. We can review each one, hovering to jump to the respective position in the text, and select the ones that are valid matches. In this way, with a single lookup, we can mark up tens of instances of an entity in the document. So our case shows that besides the standard authorities that Wolfgang showed earlier, a project can also configure a TEI publisher to query internal or alternative databases like Airtable. The Airtable connector is included in TEI Publisher, but other connectors could be adapted from sample connectors or written from scratch with a bit of TypeScript knowledge. As we added new entity types to our Airtable database, we were able to quickly register the corresponding annotation buttons in our TEI Publisher application. And this only needed some knowledge of HTML. We were able to further customize which fields are queried and how the results were displayed. We encourage other projects to try out the TEI Publisher web-based annotation facility for your annotation and enrichment needs. And we welcome your questions and suggestions here or in the eEditions Slack channel.